So here I have a simple program to print a string to the console. If I go and assembly this code right here, this ASM file, as you can see right here, I run it, hello world from assembly. And as you can see here on the code, this printing is done by this procedure right here, this showString procedure. Our project could be much bigger than this, and one of the things that sometimes we want to do is take pieces of this code and put it on different files. We can do this by here on the data segment, use the include directive, and then, for example, we indicate a file with the inc extension. Let me create this file. So it will be proc, and the extension will be inc. Yes. Let me open it here on Notepad. And now that we have this new inc file, we can copy this procedure, this showString procedure, to the file we just created. Cool. So it's exactly the same procedure that we are using, and we call this procedure the same way. So basically, on the data segments, we use the include directive, passing as argument the name of the file. The file is on the same folder. And then we have a proc.inc file with the procedure we want. If you run this now, you'll see that we get an error. And this is because we are calling a procedure from a different file, from a different code segment. So to fix this on this procedure on the other file, we just do a var. And now we will be possible to assembly the code. No errors, and if we run it, it's the same thing. So we just took that procedure, that showString procedure, and put it on a different file. One of the things that sometimes we want to do is, instead of having the file on exactly the same folder as the, in this case, demo.asm file, sometimes we have, for example, a folder, let's call it folder, with our inc file. So I basically took the inc file and put it right here on the folder. If we try to assembly again, we'll say that the proc.inc file is not found. To fix this, we just use this syntax right here. And if you try to run it again, no errors. And let's try to finish assembly. Let's run it, and as you can see, we include successfully the other .inc file in our project.